Today, I'll walk you through how you can add multiple locations to your WordPress website. This is perfect if you have a local business and you have multiple locations for the business and you want to showcase them on your website. To do this, we're going to install a plugin called All-in-One SEO. If you're in the local SEO arena or if you need to improve your search engine rankings for your website, then All-in-One SEO will work perfectly for you. To get started, you want to head over to All-in-One SEO. Go ahead and create an account. You want to log in because the local SEO pack is what we're looking for. While we're here, let's also go ahead and copy our license key. And now we can head back over to our dashboard so we can install it. We're going to go to plugins, add new. And instead of searching for the plugin, we're going to upload. You can choose file. I have mine down here, so I'm going to left click, drag this up, install now, and activate the plugin as well. From here, you'll need to enter your license key. You can either enter it and activate it here, or if you ever need to come back to work in All-in-One SEO, you can come over to the left, All-in-One SEO, add license key. I'm gonna scroll down and paste the license key that we copied before and go ahead and click connect. Once it's connected, a wizard will show up. The wizard makes it really easy to set All-in-One SEO up, but for this, I'm just going to walk you through the process of adding the local SEO. I'll have a whole link in the description below if you want to walk through the whole process of installing and configuring All-in-One SEO for your website. Over on the left, we're looking for local SEO. So let's click on this. And you see it's all kind of grayed out and you need to activate or enable it. Let's go ahead and activate local SEO. This is where the power of being able to add multiple locations to your website comes in. So from here, right out of the box, we are doing multiple locations. So we want to click the toggle to yes. Once we say yes to this, we can scroll down. Let's go to advanced locations and you'll see a little bit of information here. By default, it'll add a location slug to your permalinks or to your URL structure. You can also use a custom one. If you don't like that, you can use something else. Same thing with the category. If you have different categories, you can use that here. For this, we're just going to leave it like it is because I like those. You can also do enhanced search. And what this will do is it'll allow you to have your multiple locations show up in the WordPress site search area. Once we're finished with this area, let's go ahead and click save changes. Now we want to go to the opening hours tab so we can set those up. We can show opening hours and this will be by default. Don't worry in a second. If you have different hours for the different locations, then I'll show you how you can change that. But for now, we're just doing the opening hours and we're gonna scroll down to showcase what the different labels are. So if you're open 24 hours, it'll say that here. And if you want to change that, you can do that here. If you're closed on certain times, it'll show closed. So you can change that here. You can also choose the settings. If you're open 24/7, then it automatically just defaults that to 24/7. Or you can also use the 24-hour format if you want. Now we can set our hours. And by default, it goes through like a typical 9-to-5 for most businesses. And you can choose what days are closed. And so it will close those items. You can also toggle to change these on different days as well. Once we've set up all of our hours, let's go ahead and click save changes again. Okay, that has set up our default hours for our business in itself. We want to add multiple locations now. So over on the left, we're looking for something called locations and it's up here. You can click on all locations. We won't have any right now, but this is where we can add new locations. And this is where you can add all of your information for each location. I'll just say that we have a bike store. Once you've added all the information, you want to scroll all the way down. We're looking for the local business area. And this is where you can add the information. From here, you want to give it the name of your business, the type, and you can choose from here. From here, you can upload or select an image. I'll drop one in. Make sure to add your alt text. From here, you want to put in the address for this particular one. Once you have the address, you can also go to opening hours. And like I spoke about earlier, if you don't want to use the default hours that you set up, we can say no here because maybe this one has specific hours. So you can do that here. We want to show the opening hours and you can change this up. So maybe Monday we're closed. but Tuesday through Friday we're open. And so that's a little bit different. Once you add all of this information down here in, we can scroll all the way back up and we can actually add some of this information up here. Cool thing about bringing in these blogs by All-in-One SEO is we can just update the information in one location and then it'll update everywhere where we have it. So from here, we're going to choose to add a block. I'm going to type in AIO SEO, and there are a few ones that we want to bring in. We want to bring in the local business information. And then I'm going to do it again. I'm going to click on the add block, do AIO SEO, and I'm looking for local open hours. We'll add that in as well. And we can click on this and you see over on the display, we can show if we want to showcase the ones that are missing. So the ones that were closed, let's go ahead and close those. And then we can update that. And now we can open this and see this in action. Great. So now that's our south side. We want to do this again for our north side location or however many locations you have. And then you'll have this information for search engine rankings. And if you want to see the full breakdown of how to install and set up All-in-One SEO for your website to improve search engine rankings, then watch this video next as I walk you through step-by-step on how to install and configure All-in-One SEO for your site. And I'll see you over there.